The war in Ukraine and the recent Israel-Iran conflict have underscored a stark reality. Effective air defense is non-negotiable. It's a shield safeguarding national security, vital infrastructure, and countless lives, both military and civilian. As missile technology advances at an alarming pace, modern warfare demands air defense systems that are not just robust, but agile and constantly evolving to counter the escalating threat. The US military's air defense systems are a shield of unparalleled sophistication, designed to counter an ever-expanding array of aerial threats. At the heart of this multi-layered defense network are two powerful systems: Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, or THAAD, and Patriot. The Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, or THAAD, system has proven to be a highly efficient instrument for the United States in extending its global influence. This system plays a vital role in the United States' strategy to establish a comprehensive, multi-tiered ballistic missile defense network. Just days before the end of the year, amidst heightened tensions in the region and Pyongyang's missile tests, on December the 28th, 2023, six THAAD launchers found their home in Guam. But the THAAD shield isn't just about North Korea. As a rising military power in the Pacific, China views the system with suspicion, worrying that it could undermine its strategic capabilities. If pointed at China, this system's radar system might be used to track missile launches within a 621-mile radius. The high altitude in the name refers to the capability of the system to intercept incoming missiles at endo- and exo-atmospheric altitudes, with a maximum engagement altitude of around 93 miles above the surface of the Earth. THAAD's high altitude intercept capability reduces the impact of enemy weapons before they hit the ground, and its non-explosive kinetic effect, hit to kill, minimizes the possibility of detonation. In plain English, missile meets missile in mid-air, both missiles go boom. THAAD's massive firepower, up to 72 interceptors per battery, competent organic radar, and potent battle manager file control capability that is interoperable with other ballistic missile defense system parts, were all expressly built to counter mass raids. Nearly all sources agree that the THAAD missile system is developed to defend against hostile incoming threats like short-range, medium-range, and intermediate-range ballistic missiles, but not ICBMs. The system's interceptor missile has a single-stage, thrust-vectoring, solid-fuel rocket Pratt & Whitney Rocketdyne motor. The missile can reach a peak speed of about 8 times the speed of sound, placing it in the hypersonic category. The THAAD battery typically uses 2 mobile tactical operations centers, 6 to 9 launch vehicles holding 8 missiles each, and a ground-based radar. The launch vehicle is a modified Oshkosh Truck Corporation Heavy Expanded Mobility Tactical Truck with Load Handling System, or HEMTTLHS. The ground-based radar used for surveillance, threat classification, and threat identification is the Raytheon System's ANTPY-2 radar system for the THAAD. This missile interceptor can also be combined with military surveillance satellites like Brilliant Eyes. The sequence of a THAAD interception would start with an enemy launching a missile. The missile would be detected by the THAAD radar system when falling into range, and the information would be relayed to the fire control center. The fire control center would then instruct the launch of an interceptor missile. The target object data and predicted intercept point would be downloaded to the missile, and the missile would be fired from the launcher at an enemy projectile. The information on the target and interception would be continuously transmitted to the missile while in flight, and the enemy projectile destroyed when it re-entered the atmosphere. Lockheed Martin teams have successfully integrated the THAAD weapon system with the PAC-3 Missile Segment Enhancement, or MSE. This integration broadens the defended area and gives the forces flexibility, bringing new and far-reaching capabilities. A Patriot launcher carrying PAC-3 MSE missiles can now be integrated into a THAAD battery. As a result, the MSE's kinematic capability can be fully utilized with the THAAD's radar range. The PAC-3 MSE interceptor can launch earlier owing to integration into the THAAD weapon system, significantly increasing the MSE defended area. In a February 2022 test, the team launched a PAC-3 MSE using the THAAD weapon system against a simulated target. This test was conducted organically by the THAAD weapon system. Now, the battle manager can smartly choose between the PAC-3 MSE or THAAD interceptor, while at the same time defending a larger battle space. BAE Systems is developing the THAAD Seeker that will utilize sensors to lock onto approaching ballistic missiles traveling up to 17,000 miles per hour. This will allow the missile guidance system to direct the THAAD interceptor to the threat. THAAD manufacturer Lockheed Martin is interested in developing an extended range THAAD variant to counter hypersonic glide vehicles, including China's own WU-14. The THAAD ER system, with an improved seeker and a two-stage rocket, will give the interceptors three times the range. While THAAD might conceivably have its ICBM intercept capabilities improved, THAAD ER and other upgrades exist only as design concepts for now. It's probably unnecessary to mention that the Patriot systems have been the world's most famous air defense system since the Gulf War. It was first deployed in the 1980s and quickly became a key component of US power projection, as well as a premier symbol of US commitment to allies and partners. Patriot is an acronym for Phased Array Tracking Radar for Intercept on Target, the name given to what was previously known as SAM-D. Patriot systems have four operational functions: communications, command and control, radar surveillance, and missile interceptor guidance. It is a modular and mobile system. In less than an hour, a battery-sized element can be installed. The fire control section, that is radar set, engagement control system, antenna mast setup, and electric power plant, and launchers are all truck or trailer mounted. The heart of the Patriot battery is the fire control section. The AN-MPQ-53, or 6565A radar set, provides detection and tracking of targets as well as fire control. The phased array radar helps guide interceptors to their targets and is resistant to jamming. The radar detects fighters at a range of 68 to 81 miles, bombers at a range of 99 to 118 miles, missiles at a range of 53 to 62 miles, warhead of the missile at a range of 37 to 43 miles. The ANMSQ-104 Engagement Control Station calculates trajectories for interceptors and controls the launching sequence. It communicates with the launcher stations and other Patriot batteries. It is the only manned station in the Patriot fire unit. The OE-349 antenna mast group is the main communications backbone for the Patriot unit, and the EPP-3 electric power plant provides the power for the system. The system's missiles are transported and launched from the M901 launching station, which can carry up to 4 PAC-2 missiles, M904LS with 16 PAC-3 missiles, or M903LS, which can be configured to carry PAC-2, PAC-3, and MSE Sky Scepter missiles in various combinations. The phased array radar set tracks the Patriot missile after it's launched. The interceptor missile's active seeker will direct the missile to the target as it approaches. A PAC-2 Patriot missile will detonate near the threat missile, whereas a PAC-3 Patriot missile will attempt to impact the threat ballistic missile's warhead. The PAC-3's radar has improved detection and tracking ranges. It also has better discrimination capabilities. The radar can tell whether an aircraft is manned or not, as well as which of several re-entering ballistic objects is carrying ordnance. Additionally, the PAC-3 software ensures that ballistic missiles with chemical warheads or early release submunitions are destroyed at a specific altitude. It has a range of about 24.8 miles, an altitude of 12.4 miles, and can reach speeds of up to Mach 4.1. Despite being among the world's top-tier systems, the Patriot batteries are identifiable due to their distinct radar frequencies, which Russia can detect and target with its advanced missiles. Each Patriot battery is a noticeable presence on the battlefield, and they lack the mobility seen in some of Ukraine's more agile defense systems. The US and Germany supplied Ukraine with the Patriot weapon system, the most expensive weapons system contribution at an estimated cost of $1.1 billion each. Shortly after becoming operational, one of Ukraine's Patriot batteries near Kiev identified over a dozen incoming Russian missiles, including 6 Kinzhals from approximately 125 miles away. All were intercepted, the last one being just 9 miles out. Following that incident, Ukraine has claimed to have intercepted Kinzhal missiles on 3 further occasions. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the US military's air defense systems. So, what do you think about these formidable weapons? How effective are they? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the systems mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, operated one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.